April's Main Street to the World, and we're in SeaWorld today. Can't wait to see everything. They have the Seven Seas Food Festival going on right now, so let's take a walk around. It's a really busy day today. With the Seven Seas Food Festival, they do have concerts every weekend. And I know tonight Vanilla Ice is performing. And I guess he has a lot of fans because the park is really pretty busy. I love the animal exhibits here. And we'll actually sit back because we can see Manta getting ready to take off. That's the ride where you actually lay flat on your stomach. My son loves it. I'm not about to go on it. Yeah. And back to my speed, we have the pelicans. I know, not nearly as exciting, but unfortunately, Dolphin Day is. The dolphin show isn't running today, but I do have another vlog that I'll add into the comments for the link for it so you can see the show if you'd like to see the show. Now we're coming up on the Journey to Atlantis ride, and my kids went to go ride the ride. This is interesting because it is a water ride with a drop and a big splash, but it's also an indoor coaster. And one time my son and I went on it because I can do water rides. I can do the flume rides without too much issue with the one drop. So we went on it, and then I didn't realize it was an indoor coaster. So then there was the oh crap moment when the coaster kicked in the dark. Had no idea it was coming. It doesn't last long. It's probably, you know, I don't know, very few turns, but I'm not doing it again. So you can see, you do get a little wet on it. It's not too bad. And then after the drop, spoiler alert, is when, oh, water spout, is when the roller coaster kicks in. So it's deceiving. Another time my son rode this ride and he was, I'll say 10. You know, he wasn't too little, but certainly not too big. And we're waiting for him to come off the ride because he did ride by himself. He was old enough and big enough. Like, why isn't he coming off the ride? So I go through the back way to where the exit is, and he's about 4 feet away from the exit, but the ride had stopped. And because the ride had stopped and he wasn't at the specific exit, they wouldn't let him off the ride. Understandable. I mean, we definitely understand safety, but it was strange that he was gone for so long and I'm just waiting. So inside there is an aquarium, and we'll go take a peek at that. So it's nice on the ride because you go by the tanks. God, these guys are really cool. Moon jellyfish. Just look at them. There's so many in there. Oh, there's little tiny ones. Really pretty. Tropical, so you've got platinum crownfish, green chromis, yellow tang, all kinds of corals. Really pretty. And these are a golden trevally. Wow. It does look so pretty on that blue background. They're enormous. And here's another tank with pompanos, neon gobies, green moray eel. Oh, there he is. Can you see him in the corner? Very cool. The kids got off Journey to Atlantis, and now we're headed to see the manatees. See some fish. Oh, there he is. He's having lunch. Oh, look at. Oh, look at this guy right here. They have underwater viewing. Oh, look it. There's some small ones over there. There's six of them. I just love them. I want to hug them. He's eating his salad. Now we're going into Turtle Trek to see the turtles. And I believe they do have manatee viewings in here as well. Oh, we got a manatee butt. Look at all the little guppies. Tons of. Oh, look at how cute he is. And baby manatee. You're next. They're so sweet. The turtle's taking naps. And here he comes to visit. Here's just an overview of the park so you get an idea of what's going on. We are in the bottom left corner with the manatees and Turtle Trek and Dolphin Cove. So we're going to see the dolphins and then see the stingrays and then work towards the rest of the park. And this is dolphin underwater viewing. I love the dolphins, especially the baby nursery here. Oh my goodness, they're so cute. So cute. Well, this one keeps doing somersaults. I think he's rubbing his face on those rocks. Piece of coral. It's like scratching his chin. There he goes. Here's the overlook area where you can do dolphin feeding. And we're coming up to Allie's favorite area, the Stingray Lagoon, where you can pet the stingrays and you can feed them. It's one of my favorite spots too. They do have barriers up to try to help people to stay distanced. Did you like it? Now, while we're here, we do need your help by wearing. ride on Manta. It is an hour wait right now. You really can't bring anything with you on the ride, but they do have lockers around the park. So at least you can keep your things safe while you go on the rides. So you can see some of the track from Manta in the background. They do have people walking around too, reminding people to put their masks on. You know, it is still a situation, so definitely recommended that to wear masks to help keep you and everyone else safe. Manta running, they do only run one train at a time. It's a really quick ride. I mean, I think that's like all of like 30 seconds, but pretty intense. I'm gonna show you some of the Seven Seas Food Festival. And it's running Friday, Saturdays, and Sundays through May 9th. You can get a sampling package. Here's a sample menu for the Caribbean market. And there's over 200 food and drink options. Doghead Brewery and Cupcake Vineyards. So plenty of adult beverages. Here's SeaWorld's calendar lineup. So right now we have the Seven Seas Food Festival till May 9th. And then there's gonna be Electric Ocean Remix that'll be happening in May. They will have the Halloween Spooktacular this year. And then of course, the SeaWorld Christmas. So still lots of fun things to see this year. And you can see some of the little ducks. We love ducks. My son would love to have a duck. I told him he can have a duck when he moves out. He can have as many ducks as he wants in his own place. They have the dolphin nursery, and there is a line to get in, so they are trying to keep everyone social distance near the nursery. Last time there were 5 dolphins that were in there swimming. And you can sit right by the glass and they come up and say hello. Hello!
Hello.
Good, how are you?
Good.
You're on.
Just taking a break for a little while.
Yep, taking a break. Hanging out.
More people, or is it just you two?
I have one more. Okay. My daughter's here as well.
Okay, awesome. Yeah. Have fun today.
Thank you. Have a great day. And this is the information center, so you can go and you can buy tasting lanyards. And you can get a little overview of the park here. It's nice, they have a live guitarist and singer at the bar at Seafire Grill. And there you can see some of Icebreaker that is scheduled, supposed to open this spring. Haven't heard a ETA yet. And you can see a view of Icebreaker here. So the ride will start towards the left. It comes around, it starts to go up the big loop, and then it actually goes backwards up to that lift on the left to gain momentum, because then it will go forwards again to go over the loop. It goes around behind where we can see, and it comes in front, goes near the water, and then goes in. We did see it doing some test runs, and it doesn't seem to be a long ride, but I bet that back and forth is pretty intense. So you can see it, that's the new Icebreaker. Here you can see a little up close of the train. And then that lift that the ride uses to get momentum. so it can make the loop on the other side. So I'm going to show you a test run of Icebreaker. They have two trains to run. Here it goes. It looks like it takes off backwards. And then it goes up the little lift. And attempts to get up to the loop. Falls back down, so it looks like there are three rows per car, three cars per train, and two persons per row. So a little corkscrew over the loop. Then it does some corkscrew behind the stadium. And here it comes. Through the Wild Arctic building. The attraction is not running right now, but the exhibits are open and you do have to go through the gift shop to see them. And it's nice and cool in here. It's a really hot day, so this feels good. Some seals. They don't look like belugas though.
I think they're sea lions.
They may be sea lions. I didn't see if they had ears or not. It's a really pretty exhibit in here. Is he over there? Isn't that the walrus? I think that's the walrus. I know you're just guessing.
I remember going downstairs and seeing the belugas.
Well, I think they have the viewing windows. But I think the beluga is normally in this tank. But let's see. He might be sleeping. This should be the walrus tank.
Look at his eyes.
But he looks like an old man, doesn't he? Oh, there he is. Oh, there's another one.
What is that?
I think it is.
Oh, hello, sir.
I don't want to see you. Oh,
here he is, coming over to say hi. Look at his face. Look at his flipper. It's just huge. He's so cute. Thank you, Mr. Walrus. That's awesome. Here's the outside of Wild Arctic. We saw the walruses and sea lions inside. And here's some more booths for the Seven Seas Food Festival, the Mexican Market, the Gulf Coast Market, and the Beer Garden. And that leads into Sesame Street Land. If you have not brought the kids to Sesame Street Land, you really need to, because it really is amazing. I can't film in there, you're not supposed to, so unfortunately I can't share more than this with you, but definitely take the kids. But here you can see the markets. Really cute. Nicely themed, it's very popular. Definitely a busy day. Beer garden, you can go sit and relax and just enjoy. And here is the example of a menu for the Gulf Coast Market. Beignets, bourbon barbecue, smoked po'boys, and fried oyster po' boy. Infinity Falls is a newer attraction in SeaWorld, and it is a water ride. There you can see some of the raft ride. It's a winding river. And here's them coming down. And the little kids love it on the bridge. You can't get pretty wet on Infinity Falls. I know when my kids rode it before, they got soaked. So, of course with those, it's always luck of the draw as to where you sit. Now we're gonna go see the sharks. This is really cool. Just some little guys. And here's a giant moray eel. Wow. Yeah, there's another one behind him. It's cute, and they still have kids' activities open. Sharks under attack. 100 million sharks are killed every year by people mainly to make shark fin soup. Wow. Look at the soft shark. Sawfish.
Jacob, look down at the moving quark so you don't trip. And then look around. Once it's over, Jacob.
Very cool. There's a shark. I don't know my sharks.
Right above you, Jacob.
Oh, there's a giant ray. Oh, look at the teeth.
Jacob, look up.
Wow. Oh wow, he's gorgeous. I don't know what they are. They are telling us. See, there's a small tooth sawfish. That's what we saw. We saw baby black tips. Very cool. Oh, look at the nurse shark just hanging out. Isn't she pretty? A couple more sharks to say goodbye. Oh, that's a cool exhibit. Definitely check that out. And here's the outdoors display of different sharks. Some smaller sharks. And rays. And then that is the bar at Sharks Underwater Grill. And then Sharks Underwater Grill restaurant. So you can see the tank of sharks in the background. Very cool. Oh, look at him, he's getting chased. We are getting ready to leave the the park, but I just wanted to show you the front end when it's a little less busy out here. It was way too busy when we first came in to be able to show you. There's plenty of opportunity to do extra things. You can have animal interactions, add quick queue, which is like a fast pass. The dining plan. And the SeaWorld store is there, of course. Plenty of gift shop opportunities. Just to show you an overview. I love how SeaWorld does promote their rescue efforts. They really do a tremendous amount of good things for animals. For now, I just want to say thanks for coming with us and joining in on our day. We really had a nice day. Had a lot of fun, got on some rides, saw a lot of beautiful animals. That's one of the best things about this park, is seeing the animals and just being able to appreciate them. Be sure to check back for our other videos and like and subscribe to our channel. And special thank you to our sponsor, Coasters and Castles Travel. For without them, Main Street to the World wouldn't exist. We wouldn't be able to do what we're doing. So we really appreciate it. So next time you think of vacation, think of Coasters and Castles Travel to help you. They're happy to help you, and their expertise can give you a very memorable vacation. So have a great day. Thanks.